I have a story to tell. It's a story about drug discovery and about finding the right chemical compounds to fight disease. How many compounds are out there with the potential to fight disease? Literally trillions. We begin with aspirin. Aspirin is a drug we've known about for hundreds of years. It's a chemical compound, a molecule made of carbon, oxygen, and hydrogen atoms. It works, in part, by binding to and disabling target proteins in our bodies. That's basically how small molecule drugs work, by binding to proteins which play a role in disease. So how do we replicate aspirin success and find compounds which bind to disease-enabling proteins? How do we find the therapeutic needle in the haystack? Let's say we have a protein that helps cancer cells grow. There's no way we could test, by experiment, every compound that might block the activity of that protein. There just aren't enough labs and isn't enough time. But we could use computers to rapidly screen millions of compounds in silico. We've built a system that does exactly that. It's called VirtualFlow. With VirtualFlow, we begin by preparing both the protein and the chemical compounds. For a compound, this means taking very basic information about its atoms and how they are connected and turning it into a 3D model. VirtualFlow uses as many as 100,000 computer processing cores to prepare many millions of compounds. So far, it has created models for 1.4 billion compounds that are commercially available, but it could do more. VirtualFlow also runs docking programs. Docking programs bring together the protein of interest with each compound. The program then checks whether the compound is able to bind to the protein. Each compound is able to take on many shapes. The program tests many thousands and gives each shape a stickiness score, depending on the likelihood that it will attach to the protein. This is repeated hundreds of millions of times, in parallel, by all of those computer cores. VirtualFlow then takes the stickiest compounds, the top contenders, and retests them, but this time with greater precision. With our list of likely candidates, typically about 100, we leave the virtual world, go to the lab, and test the actual compounds with actual proteins. Traditional real-world screening methods test only hundreds of thousands of compounds per experiment. VirtualFlow can test a billion or more, and it can do it faster and for far less cost. That's my story. Well, I guess you could say that's just the beginning of my story. So which compound will turn out to be the next aspirin? I can't wait to find out.